with Walla Stamping. Thanks so much for stopping by my craft room today. So, if you are like me and you want to make your own Christmas cards, now is a great time to get a jump start and start planning your cards and your packaging and that kind of thing. If you wait until the very last minute and you go into the store, first of all, you got to drive there. Secondly, you have to go in and fight the crowds because everybody else is in there trying to find their perfect Christmas card, and the boxes are all jumbled and they're in a mess. And so you've got to fight not only the crowd and the traffic, but you've got to shuffle through all of those boxes that have just been scattered here and yonder and try to find that perfect card that you want to send out. Well, why do that when you can make your own? And I know you may be busy, so let me take the stress out of Christmas card shopping, show you how to make a very clean and simple card that will literally take you 5 minutes or less to put together. So let's jump on in and get started on making this card. We're going to start out with a basic card base. Mine is in Whisper White, and I've got it cut to 5.5 by 8.5, and then I'm just going to score it and fold it at the 4.25-inch line. For the front panel, I have an additional Whisper White. This is cut to 4 by 5.25. And to stamp all of my flowers on, I just have a scrap piece, and it is just a piece left over from when I cut my paper. I've got some old olive, and this is cut to 4 inches wide by 2.75 inches tall. And then I have a piece of the gold foil, and this is also 4 inches by 1 inch. So first thing I'm gonna do is take my piece of paper that was the scrap, and I'm going to get the stamping done and out of the way first. I want to show you the stamp sets that I'm using today. One is the Pop of Petals. It's actually in the catalog this year. It's a newer stamp set. And then I'm going to use the Star of Light stamp set that was in last year's catalog. It is absolutely one of my favorites because of all the sentiments as well as the huge number of different images you can stamp. So I'm going to use my Real Red, and I'm going to be stamping one of the flowers. And as you can see, I have top written on there so that I know which way to stamp it. So when I get ready to punch it out with my punch, it will be so much easier. So I've got 3 of those stamped. That's as many as you're going to need. And next I'm going to grab my punch, and I can't really think of the name of this punch right off the top of my head, but I will have that in the list of supplies that is going to be over on my blog post, which you can also get a full instruction sheet on how to recreate this card for yourself. So simple, you can probably just watch this video and not even follow the instructions. So make sure that when we get to the end of the video that you just hop on over to my blog at wallastamping.com and take a look at the list of supplies that I've used there. If there's anything that you want to pick up, you can shop my online store from that page as well. So what I'm going to do next is grab my piece of old olive, and I'm just going to use some snail. You can use whatever adhesive you like to use. I'm just going to put that all over the back, and then I'm going to line this up even with the bottom of my front panel for my card, as well as the 2 left and right sides. Then next I'm going to put adhesive on my gold foil sheet, and I'm just going to butt that cut edge up against the old olive cut edge. Now I flip it over because inevitably, I'm never going to get my pieces cut exactly the same length. And as you can see here, I just had to trim just a wee little bit off of there because I didn't get it cut perfectly. So I'm going to take some of these dimensionals, and I'm just going to throw one on the back of each of these little flowers, and I'll be putting those down in just a minute. But before I do that, I am going to use my Tuxedo Black Memento ink and get my sentiment stamped first. So I've got the sentiment Merry Christmas out of the other stamp set that I'm using. And just like I said, I'm using my black Memento ink. I'm going to stamp that in the center of the white area of my card. So that's all the stamping that you really need to do for this card is just the flowers and your sentiment. How easy is that?
So now I'm just pulling off the backing from each of those flowers, and just make sure, now you of course can do yours however you want to. Just, I like mine all going the same direction. So when I get ready to stick them down, I just make sure that they're all turned the same way. I started out with the first one in the middle so that I make sure that I get them spaced evenly across that little gold band there. So now my card is basically done. I'm just adding a little extra adhesive to the back. And again, I'm just using snail. Take my card base, I'm going to fold that over, and you can score it if you want to. And look at that, there was a little rhinestone that came from somewhere. I don't know where he came from. So now that I'm done with that folding and burnishing, I'm just going to stick that front panel on my card, and now both of the cards are complete. As you can see on the left, maybe you can see, I'm not sure how well, but there are some embellishments in the center of each of those flowers. This is a step you don't have to do, but I like a little extra something something with my flowers. So these are the metal pearls, or metallic pearls is what they're called. They come in a set with gold and silver, and I just put a single one of the gold ones in the middle of each of these flowers.
This is only going to take you just about 4 to 5 minutes tops to make these. And if you want to make a bunch, then do an assembly line. Cut out all of your card bases and get all of your papers that you're going to need cut out. Depending on how many you're going to make, it may take you 10 to 15 minutes. And then if it only takes you about 2 minutes to put each card together, you can have a box of 12 cards in less than 30 minutes. So that's a lot better than driving to the store, fighting the crowds, fighting the traffic, and trying to find that box of cards that you may end up paying $28 for. Who wants to do that? Not me. I don't think you would either. So I hope you enjoyed this card today and that you will run to your craft room and give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this card or the Christmas in July Facebook online class that I'm going to be having, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section that's below the video, or visit my blog for complete instructions and a list of product that I've used to create this card, and I will have information over there about the online class as well. So I hope you have a great week, and I'll talk to you soon.